we need to continue to mobilize resources, especially through institutions like CDB that have pretty much been established to help us to pool our risk and access capital markets more efficiently and more effectively. Now, having said that, in order to achieve the SDGs, it's going to take quite a bit of effort. In fact, we did some estimates that suggest that basically just to achieve the poverty goal, which is to have poverty by 2030, we would need a significant increase in resources. We would need a significant increase in investment expenditure. So using the relationships between poverty and GDP growth, and then between investment and GDP growth, what we have estimated is that countries in the region would probably need to spend about 150% more in terms of investment expenditure to achieve the poverty SDG. So I'm not talking about the other 16, I'm just talking about that one SDG. So it means that we're going to have to dedicate, we're going to have to mobilize significantly more resources to achieve the SDGs. And then we're going to have to seek to utilize these resources to increase our investment spending. You know, so I think that those things are going to be critical. Mobilizing resources through the institutions, especially through the institutions that have been established to help the region to pool their risk to mobilize resources, and then upping our investment expenditures.
Gervase?
Thanks. I think this is another one of those interesting but kind of tricky questions. I do agree that we should, you know, mobilize the resources that we've created in this CDB for access to investment funding. But I really do believe that it's very, 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 very difficult for us to access funding, for us to make investments without growing our economies. And so we really ought to be interested in managing our affairs well, where the little that we have, we spend it extremely effectively. You know, we should have such laser focus on that, because largely we're not wealthy countries that can afford a lot of waste. Yet we all know there's a lot of waste in our system. And until we really start to sort of operate with a laser focus and discipline in that arena, and really drive more of our expenditure towards investment, focus on making our economies productive. It is productivity that drives growth. It is productivity that would allow our countries to be competitive, to use this emerging platform of digital technology and open platforms for us to have access to the global stage, to participate in you know, services that can be offered from anywhere on the planet. This is available to us, and we can continue to live in paradise. But we cannot make access of that as long as we continue to have economies that are shrinking. We continue to have unequal opportunities. We have to grow people out of poverty. Yes, we have to support, but the real solution to poverty is to help lift people out of the poverty, give them the education, give them the opportunities, give them the access to technology and platform that allow them to participate in a different place. And that's the key focus, because if we keep looking for like somebody to give me some investment from somewhere, and we continue to be affected by different crises, whether they're economic, whether they're health, whether they're climate, we have to find ways to grow our countries ourselves. And that requires more discipline than we've been accustomed to operating under. And I don't think there's an easy answer. There's not a simple way to do this. This is, you know, the kind of hard work that pays its own reward.
So much, and I can hear the commitment coming through in your voice, as I've heard
from Ian and from Michelle. Michelle, over to you.
So I want to sort of underpin what Gervase just said with the fact that that competitiveness that we have to be so passionate about really has to be driven by how we approach our human capital development. So a bit counter to what was shown in the poll, I really do think that a lot of the investment that we need has to be targeted at how we retool our citizens, how we create opportunity in order to embrace change and some of the new business models that we're seeing coming to the fore, because that type of creative thinking being nurtured is what will take us forward to be able to apply the technology that we have available to us in a meaningful and developmental way, so that our workforce development in terms of the younger demographic of our population should really be targeted in terms of some of the STEM disciplines. So whether it be science, technology, engineering, mathematics, I think that these elements in terms of foundational initiatives and investment is what is required in order to get us to that next level as well.